my tweed pressed, got my best vest. All I need now is the girl. Got my striped tie, got my hopes high, got the time and the place, and I got the rhythm. Now all I need's the girl to go with them.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to your show. Just this is the PM show with Mr. Robert Conrad. Thank you for joining us in the lounge today at TikiLive.com. And joining all the other chatters, conversing, and watching the live in-studio video footage at TikiLive.com. Just do a search for CRN. We're the first listing that pops up. And I am Eric Hines, the man across from me, of course, Mr. Robert Conrad. Welcome back to the show, Bob.
Yeah, thank you very much. Now, what happened to our lady that we were talking to?
The lovely Elaine is still on the line. Elaine, welcome back to your show.
Thank you, dear.
Oh, thank you very much. I'm sorry that happened to you today, Duke. I mean, my goodness, were you doing a fight scene or a stunt in your sleep?
No, dear. Sweetheart. What I was doing was getting out of the bed. And in the course of getting out of the bed, I tripped and I hit my knees and I went, oh, my goodness, I'm not the greatest stuntman in the world after all, am I? So that made me a religious person, and it was fun, and I enjoyed it, and I didn't hurt anything. I just was embarrassed, and that's all. I just shared it with you because it's the beginning of our show, and I wanted you to know because you sounded like someone that cared about me.
Yes, I do. I think you're a wonderful person.
Thank you.
You've done a lot of great things, and I love it when you share your stories. It's wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you, darling. Thanks for, you know, asking. Thanks for letting me, you know, share it with you.
Well, is Miss Sarah there tonight?
No, Miss Sarah is off. Her mother lives in Maine, and her mother is here, and she's visiting with her daughter. And it's one of those mother-daughter things. And so it'll be you and me during the show, and that's the way it's supposed to be. Okay, girl?
I think that's great. I look forward to talking to you a lot tonight. I usually talk a lot with everyone, but I felt like I needed to give you some special attention because, you know, that's what it's all about, right?
You got that right, baby. That's what it's all about.
I was amazed the more that I have read about your career and the different movies and shows and things that you have done. I think there must be a lot of jealous people out there that wish they could have done what you have.
Really?
Geez, you're looking at one of them right here. Singing. Yeah, absolutely. Man, the guy had a prolific career.
And prolific? What's that mean?
A very substantial and accomplished career.
Oh, good. Thank you for using
the word.
Plus,
man, you're like, I'm really into fitness, and you were like
buffed. Well, anyway.
You're one of the early generation of these, like, buff actor guys.
Can we move on and
I'm
talk
sorry,
to
just
this beautiful
enough
woman?
Flattery. I apologize. Yeah,
I'm sure you do. Where are you, baby?
Oh, well, I'm just listening to you guys talk.
Well, we want to listen to you, sweetheart.
Well, I just think you're multi-talented.
Thank you, baby.
Singing, wonderful voice, and just the fact that you were also a police officer for, what, 7 or 8 years?
Yeah, I think it was 8 years that was, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That had to be something to be stopped by a police officer and realize it was Robert Conrad.
Yeah, I used to say things like, could you turn your lights off, please?
You are just too funny.
Thank you, babe. Thank you, darling.
You really are a ladies' hero. I'm sure those women in that restaurant tonight, or this afternoon at lunch, you just made their day.
I had fun with them. Thank you.
They left with all smiles. That's for sure.
Well, there were four of them, and they were cute, and I enjoyed talking to them, and I enjoyed talking to you. Now we got to move on. You know why?
Because there's other people waiting.
That's right, sweetheart. There are other people waiting.
Okay,
but darling.
Well, it's been great. and I will talk to you guys next week.
I hope
All
so.
Right. Thanks, Elaine.
All right, good night.
Talk hey, good soon. Afternoon, darling.
Yes, you too, darling.
Thank you.
Woo! Got a little smoky in here.
Oh, really? You thought so? I thought it was just honest.
Hey, honest smoke.
Oh, you are so kinky.
Let's get over to Anita in Wisconsin. Anita, I need you.
Hi, Robert. How are you feeling? Oh, I shouldn't even say how you're feeling.
I'm feeling all right there. You know, I mean, I'm happy to talk to you. I just talked to a lovely lady, and now I've got you, and so you know how it goes.
Yeah, okay. So are you happy tonight? I mean, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm all right. As a matter of fact, I'm very all right, you know, but it goes like this.
I was going to say, if you're happy, then I'm happy.
I've Aww. Got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart, you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin. How is that, all right?
No, I'm really happy.
Thanks, baby.
So I want to mention this. When I called the show months and months ago, at that time I told you that I was a big fan of Doris Day's. And
yes.
She was always a big influence in my life. And you said at that time that you knew her. I wondered, how did you know her?
Oh, I just met her through the cycle of people that get together and visit. And
oh, I see.
Yeah, you know, show business is a small character of what you do.
A small community, you got all you guys.
Yeah, small community is a great way of saying it. And I ran into her and said, hey, baby, what's up? And we chatted and it was good.
Well, that's good. Well, it was her birthday this week. Could you sing happy birthday to her?
No, I didn't even know she was still with us, but I'm glad that
she turned 95.
Well, that's what I meant. I'm glad she's 95 and still with us. Well, she is with us, right?
Yeah, she is. Yep, good. She's still doing good.
Good.
So could you sing happy birthday to her?
Well, I don't know.
Let's do when we come back from break. We're going to break
if it's
right
past
now.
Tense, we don't want to say it. You never know. It might be inappropriate because she might have gone to God already.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes, maybe.
Don't even say that.
I don't know. I'm just telling you what I think. Who knows for sure?
Stick around, guys.
Well, I'm going to hang in here, okay?
Okay, hang in there,
hanging,
Anita.
Baby.
She's hanging.
Guys, as you look it up, I know you're looking it up right now.
I'm going to look it up for you, too. Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up here on the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. I'm Eric Hines, and we'll be back right after this on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
Michael Horn and Fred Dreyer for you for Solar Optimum. We come and broadcast from the Solar Optimum studios, 818-745-1489. This is a big deal. You can save energy if you put solar power on your house. Am I right, Fred Dreyer?
Well, listen, if you're tired of those offensive power bills, which I know I am, I had a bill the other day for $683. That's just completely outrageous. Anything over $150, you got to get Solar Optimum.
And they now have this Tesla battery that not only is there for you in a power outage, like an earthquake or the wind blows out the power or something hits and the power line goes out or whatever, but it's there for you in the evening to trickle in more power into your house so you can save even more money. You can go and find out more information and get that Tesla battery in your home. Am I right?
Yes, you can. And all you got to do is call 818-745-1489.
Don't be left out in the cold and the dark. Save your family. Get light in there. 818-745-1489. Solar power and the Tesla backup battery. 818-745-1489.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
If you're eligible for Medicare, you need to know there is money available to you that can lower your Medicare prescription costs. How much can you save? Find out now by making a free call to Health Markets. They'll search from a variety of nationally recognized plans to find you the right coverage at a price that fits your budget. And they'll do all this valuable research for you at no charge to you. And remember, you may be able to save money on your prescriptions. We'll tell you if you qualify. Why pay a penny more than you have to for an insurance policy? Let us find you the right plan at the right price and see if you qualify to lower your prescription costs. Put our free service to work for you at no charge. Call Health Markets right now.
800-990-0351. 800-990-0351. 800-990-0351. That's 800-990-0351.
Health Markets Insurance Agency is the DBA of InSphere Insurance Solutions, Inc. Licensed in all 50 states and DC. Service and product availability varies by state. Agents may be compensated based on your enrollment.
Estás sobre la playa de Caleta y el mar. Te baña y acaricia tu belleza sin par. Estás entre mis brazos y me dejas besar. Tu boca primavera de color, de color.
Welcome back, everybody, to your show. This is the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad, the wild, wild PM Show, starring the Duke, Mr. Conrad. And I'm Eric Hines, the consummate co-host on this wild, wild ride. And before we left the break, we had Anita hanging on a cliff there. And you were talking about Doris Day's 95th birthday. I just found out that Doris Day didn't realize that she was 95. She thought she was 93.
Yeah, I know.
Isn't that something? Yep. So, Bob, did you want to say happy birthday to Doris Day?
Yeah, Doris, happy birthday.
You don't want to sing it?
No, I don't want to sing it.
Yeah. Okay, all right. Well, you have your scruples. There you go.
Thank you very much.
Well, so he did wish her happy birthday. There we go.
Yeah, okay. So,
go ahead.
How did you get involved in karate?
In karate?
Is that how you pronounce it?
Yeah, it's karate.
Karate.
Karate?
Yeah, karate. Okay. A friend of mine back in the old days introduced me to it, and I learned to, it's kara's open hand, te is your feet. And I learned how to defend myself with my hands and my feet.
So is karate an open hand?
Yes.
Fighting style? Oh,
yes.
Interesting. Because I've been looking for an open hand fighting style. It's really cool.
What do you want an open hand fighting style for?
Because I play guitar.
It's well, why do you want a fighting style at all?
Well, because, you know, hey, a man's got to defend himself.
Well, then pull out a gun and shoot him.
Well, I'm against using weapons of that sort, sir.
Oh, so I'm a gentleman. You just want to give a kick him? Or
you know, give him a good knuckle sandwich or a nice karate chop to the neck like
karate,
Spock.
Karate. Yep.
Bah, right to the neck and just knock him out.
Oh, wow. How violent.
Get out of here with this stuff.
Well, you the guy that brought it up.
Hey. All right, anything else from you, Anita?
Well, I was going to say, I'd love to have been one of those ladies in that restaurant today.
Oh, boy.
Ooh, I would love to have had you in the restaurant myself.
It's not a bad idea, actually.
I know. We had a sweetheart.
Friends of the show luncheon at the old Lamplighter.
Ooh, don't plug it. We'll have it full next week. Don't plug it. Stop it.
Well, I love all the stories you tell about your mother. I loved it when you told the story about how she taught you how to dance and...
Yeah, she was the best, man. You were getting brought up by a female woman is a very exciting experience, and I had the privilege of being able to have that on my billboard.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, I guess I don't have anything else tonight, but I just want to wish you a happy week, and I hope that you feel better, and I hope you don't fall anymore.
Well, try not to, but it just happens sometimes, you know what I'm saying? It's
but you don't want to be falling anymore.
I won't fall anymore. How's that?
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Promise? Dear,
I promise.
You promise?
I give you my absolute positive promise.
Okay. I'll hold you to it.
So, ooh, just hold me.
Okay.
All right, baby.
Okay. Well, have a wonderful week, and I love you.
And I love you back.
Okay.
All right, thanks.
Bye, Eric.
Bye, Anita. Have a good one. Oh, that was sweet.
You got two byes. I got none. She said, bye, Eric. Bye, Eric.
You know, but you got I love you.
Yeah, but I mean, you got...
She gave me the courtesy bye. You got the I love you bye.
No, you got the depth bye.
No way.
Oh, well, by we'll ask far. Her next time she
two
calls.
Two thumbs up for Mr. Conrad for that goodbye, definitely.
Next time she calls, we'll find out what she meant by that.
All right. Here we go. Let's get over to Brian, our good buddy Brian in Nashville.
Brian in Nashville, Brian, what are you doing now? What are you doing talking to us again?
Well, I'm having a good time talking to you guys. Just listen to the show.
Well, good. I'm glad,
man. Got a little adult beverage here in the Pine Panel Study and just kicking back and saying, man, this is nice talking to Uncle Bob.
That sounds like a good plan.
Well, good. What time is it in Nashville?
It is now 5:28.
All right.
Oh, wow, it's late.
It's dinner time.
I'm glad you're talking to us at 5:28.
It's cocktail time.
Huh? There you go.
God bless you. Do the cocktails.
I'm going to keep it short. I know you lost a good friend. I don't know if you knew, but you probably did. Don Rickles, you know.
Yeah, I knew him really well, frankly.
So I hate to hear that, and I'm sure, you know, you could tell us a story about, I'm going to hang up and listen, when he was on the Wild Wild West.
Sure you could. Okay, thanks for your call, and... thanks
and
for giving
y'all have
him
a great one, and I'll talk to you next week.
Okay, and thanks for giving him your courtesy. That's a kind word, a kind thing.
Yeah. Well, thank you, sir. All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up here on the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. Join us in the lounge. Go to tikilive.com, TIKILIVE.com.
What lounge are we in? You keep referring to the lounge.
It's the lounge at tikilive.com.
It's a studio.
That's where they can watch our video. That's Tiki Live right there.
All right, whatever. Can you help me up?
Yeah, I'll get you out of here in just a second, sir.
I'm sitting on my
You took us? Okay, guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up. We'll be back right here on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
For the getaway of your dreams, come to Hawaii's Playground, Ka'anapali Beach Resort, on the fun side of Maui, where the world comes to play. Find your spot on Ka'anapali Beach with 3 miles of white sand, 12 resort properties, 2 golf courses, and 2 shopping centers. Enjoy the playground of Hawaii's ancient royalty. Ka'anapali Beach Resort is Hawaii's original master planned destination resort and home of the Hawaii Food and Wine Festival. With views of 2 neighboring islands, you can breathe in the land's natural beauty from your favorite resort or golf fairway. Come experience Ka'anapali's own special brand of Hawaiian hospitality with world-class dining, relaxing resorts, water sports, and activities of every kind. For romantic, family, and great friend getaways, discover the options of Ka'anapali Beach Resort, where the world comes to play. Plan your getaway today. Visit ka'anapaliresort.com. That's K-A-A-N-A-P-A-L-I-Resort.com.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last, but you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and SmartFares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines, and you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
Hey there, did you know that with a bachelor's degree, on average, you could make almost twice as much over a lifetime than a person with just a high school diploma? It's true. According to the 2012 U.S. Census Bureau, college grads with a bachelor's degree make almost twice as much as high school grads. Now, going back to school is easier than ever at Independence University. Log on and complete coursework from the park, or the beach, or even your couch watching the kids. And Independence University gives you the tools, a free tablet and laptop, for undergrad students to use and keep when they graduate. That's right. Get a laptop so you can go to college from anywhere. Take the first step to a new career in business, information technology, healthcare, or graphic arts. Call to find the online degree program that's right for you, and you could be on your way to increasing your earning potential.
800-989-1361. 800-989-1361. That's 800-989-1361.
Come to Angelo's and Vinci's Restaurante in Fullerton, California for our sizzling party savings. Book your wedding event or reception, your birthday bash, or a special event of any kind and celebrate at Angelo's and Vinci's. Come to Angelo's and Vinci's and celebrate in one of our many festive banquet rooms. It's an incredible fun event you'll never forget. Food, music, and lots of fun. Call for the details and don't forget our daily lunch and dinners, plus our Sunday champagne brunch, just $14.95. Minestrone soup, sausage and peppers, pastas, chicken dishes, salads, scones and muffins, plus so much more. A chocolate fondue fountain, zamplis, cannolis, fresh fruit, champagne, and Junior will be waiting to make the omelet of your choice from our omelet bar. Angelo's and Vinci's has been voted on the Orange County Hot List as one of the top five Italian restaurants for the past 6 years. And don't forget our award-winning pizzas. Thin or thick, they're yummy. All at Angelo's and Vinci's Restaurante at 550 North Harbor Boulevard in Fullerton, California. Call 714-879-4022. 714-879-4022.
In my life I have someone who needs me, someone I've needed so long. For once unafraid I can go where my life leads me, and somehow I know I'll be strong. For once I can touch what my heart used to dream of, long before I knew someone, one like you would make my
Welcome back, everybody. This is the Wild Wild PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad, the voice of Sammy Davis, bringing us back in here. I'm Eric Hines, the consummate co-host on this Wild Wild ride, and the man across from me, the reason why we are all here, host of your show, Mr. Robert Conrad.
What does that mean, consummate?
It means kind of brings it all together.
Oh, good. Now you're saying the audience that we're listening to brings it all together?
I bring the audience to you. And you to the audience, I am the consummator of this holy matrimony that we have created here.
Well, all I can say is without them, there wouldn't be us.
That's exactly right,
sir. And I'm so handsome to have them with us. So please, and I want to say one thing to all of you, to Valerie, Pat, for Christoph, and John. I thank you, and I thank you, I thank you for our friendship. And I mean that sincerely and from the bottom of my heart. I mean that.
Well, speaking of Christoph, we do have the man himself on the line dialing us all the way from France.
From France.
Christoph, welcome to your show.
Is that the same as saying France?
This is.
Okay.
This is. Bonsoir, amigo. Hello. Hey.
Bonjour, amigo.
Bonjour. Yeah, excuse me.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Always, Uncle Bob, it's always with great joy that I find you in my weekly radio show.
Well, thank you.
I expect always forward because it's the meeting where I find you and hear you to tell us all these stories around your career and on your life. It's very important for me to hear you.
Thank you.
As usual, I have prepared my three weekly questions for the show. First, during your career, you have created your own production company named The Shane Company. Can you explain us the reason why you created this company?
Yeah, because Shane is the name of my son.
Yes, I know.
And I just thought it was appropriate to name something that I held in a dear way after the man I loved with all my heart. So this became The Shane Company. And it was French, and it was good, I thought.
But why you created this company? What's the reason?
Well, because how else do you want to make films? And what else do you want to say if you reach a certain point in your career where you've worked and worked and worked for other people under other circumstances? You want to make a film, and you call it what? What? I know.
Okay.
Let's call it The Shade Company, which we did.
Okay, Uncle Rob. For my second question, at a point in your career, you have decided to become a filmmaker. Can you explain this choice to become director?
Yes, because that's what I felt was appropriate. I wanted to find something that would entertain the public with the material that I found personally attractive. And so I went on and I'd do a movie and I'd say, let's do that for the Shane Company. And we did it.
Okay, Uncle Bob. Finally, I heard an interview with Ross Martin from 1980 when he said that a third Wild Wild West TV movie was in production. Unfortunately, he passed away before start filming. Can you tell us more about this project?
No, I can't, because he died ahead of time. He was very young, and I found it to be totally unfortunate. And we went on without Ross.
We don't know never about the scenario of the stories of that Wild Wild West TV movie news.
I don't understand that question.
One more time, Christoph.
You don't know. You don't know never about the scenario of the of this new movie about Wild Wild West series. You don't know never about the scenario.
The scenario?
No, I don't. I don't. I really don't. I know it was a great experience, and I know it was an opportunity to make some marvelous more films, but we never got that opportunity.
Okay, Uncle Bob. That's it for my phone call. I conclude repeating you hold the love and admiration that I have for you. Thanks for being you, who you are, a man and a sincere artist close to your public.
Well, thank you very much, and it's public, not my public. Say it again.
Your public, no. you're a great artist, Uncle Bob.
No, say it again. It's not public, it's public.
Public.
Perfect.
Okay,
perfect. Yes. Yay, perfect.
Christoph, great job on your English lesson today, sir. Thank you.
Bye, my friend. Have a good show. God bless you. Take care. God bless you next week.
Bonsoir.
Thank you, and God bless you, and God bless all of the public people who are listening.
Au revoir, public.
Au revoir.
Au revoir. All right. There we go. All right. There goes Christoph. Now moving on to our good buddy, Mr. Pole Position himself, John in Virginia. John, welcome to your show.
Hey, Bob. Hey, Eric. How you all doing?
Hey, John.
Hey, John. Is that you?
That's me.
God, your Man, voice sounds...
It sounds great, doesn't it?
Are you sure we got the right guy?
Whatever his cell phone carrier is, he's got a great carrier.
Man, what a great
Well,
voice.
No, this is a landline, so...
Oh, that's why.
Is that what it is? I don't know who the hell I'm talking to, but it sounds good. Now, who is this?
This is John the Voice.
I knew it. See, you tried to kid me.
Tried to trick you.
Hey, John, you yes, can't sir. Fool the old fooler.
That's right.
All right.
Well, Bob, I'd like to start off by saying rest in peace, Don Rickles, the comedy legend and the king of insults. Right now, Don Rickles is in heaven insulting an angel by saying he's seen better wings at KFC.
You got that one right. And just for the record, my name isn't Bob. My name is Conrad Robert Falk.
Conrad Robert Norton Falk.
You got it, brother. Thank you for clearing the...
in the air, yeah.
You know, talking about Don Rickles, he made his film debut in a small role in a movie that you passed the test and was supposed to be in, called Run Silent, Run Deep with Burt Lancaster.
Right on. Yeah. You got that right.
And, of course, Don was in the episode The Night of the Druid's Blood on the Wild Wild West, and that episode aired March 25th, 1966.
Oh, man, you're so on top of your game. Thank you for sharing that with me and for the audience that's still alive and still exists, and I'm one of them, okay?
Okay, and I've got some more trivia if you want some after the break.
Of course I want. Yeah. I love your trivia. It's not trivia. It's reality stuff, man. Come
that's
on.
Right. All right. Well, I'll be back with the real deal after this word from our sponsor.
Okay. Now, one question before we go to commercial.
Uh-huh.
How's your wife?
She's great.
Good. I'm glad.
Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up here on the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. We'll be back right here in the lounge.
Michael Horn and Fred Dreyer for you for Solar Optimum. We come and broadcast from the Solar Optimum studios, 818-745-1489. This is a big deal. You can save energy if you put solar power on your house. Am I right, Fred Dreyer?
Well, listen, if you're tired of those offensive power bills, which I know I am, I had a bill the other day for $683. That's just completely outrageous. Anything over $150, you got to get Solar Optimum.
And they now have this Tesla battery that not only is there for you in a power outage, like an earthquake or the wind blows out the power or something hits and the power line goes out or whatever, but it's there for you in the evening to trickle in more power into your house so you can save even more money. You can go and find out more information and get that Tesla battery in your home. Am I right?
Yes, you can. And all you got to do is call 818-745-1489.
Don't be left out in the cold and the dark. Save your family. Get light in there. 818-745-1489. Solar power and the Tesla backup battery. 818-745-1489.
These are the sounds of Colombo's Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club.
Mm, look at this ribeye. You see that ribeye?
Fantastic. Ah, incredible.
This is delicious.
Sausage and lentil soup. Special today. Very, very good.
Look at this garlic bread. Best garlic bread I've ever had.
And here's Vic Perino, owner and operator of Colombo's.
A lot of the Italian recipes are my uncle's own recipes. We have a lot of people coming back for his hand-rolled lasagna. We make it basically from scratch. I think ours is exceptional.
Here's Vic on what makes Colombo's different than any other Italian restaurant.
The other thing that sets us apart from other Italian restaurants is that we're an Italian steakhouse. We specialize in our steaks.
Plus, there's more.
We have entertainment 7 nights a week. So they're coming for a lot of reasons to value. Their value per dollar that they're getting, plus coming into a neighborhood-friendly place. That, you know, sometimes we're actually accused of being the melting pot of Eagle Rock.
Colombo's in Eagle Rock on Colorado Boulevard. 323-254-9138. Mangia.
Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wandering in the night. What were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through? Something in your eyes was so inviting. Something in your smile was so exciting. Something in my heart told me I must have you. Strangers in the night.
Welcome back, everybody. The PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. Thank you for joining us in TikiLive.com, TikiLive.com at the lounge, where you can watch live in-studio video footage and chat with other CRN listeners. The lounge at Tiki Live, they actually have a really great place to chat with other viewers of the show and watch the video footage.
Oh, is that why it's called a lounge?
Yeah, it's good. You kind of chill out and relax in there.
Oh, chill out is good.
Yeah, chilling out's good.
We could call it the chill out lounge.
The chill lounge.
The chill lounge. Well, something.
Something like that. I like that, though. I like your input on that one. Let's get back over to John, the voice, John in Virginia, who has some more Robert Conrad factoids available to us. Bob, bring that mic down a little bit for me.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. Absolutely.
Is that good?
That's perfect. Here we go. John, welcome back, sir.
Hey, thank you, Eric. Thank you, Bob.
Sure.
The last show of 1966 was the night of the bogus bandits, with Michael Dunn returning in his arch-villain role and Roland Lestarza, the former heavyweight contender. Now, didn't he train you while he was filming that episode, Bob?
Who was that?
Roman Esparza?
Roland Lestarza.
Oh, yeah. Roland trained me. Yeah, absolutely. Sure he did. Yeah.
And this is Dick Kanji talking. He says, also making his first appearance as a stuntman on the show was Eddie Dono. I met Eddie at Chuck Bale's house when Chuck was trying to teach me to stunt fight and used Eddie to help him demonstrate. I saw the opportunity to repay Eddie for his help and asked Bob to give him a one-line part that was followed by the man getting knocked out by West. Bob told me the part was slated for me, but I figured I was working the show with or without the part, so I agreed to give it to Eddie. I figured the part would give Eddie an opportunity to show Bob his ability and earn him a chance to work with us again. In this show, there are a couple of good fight sequences that have Bob fighting several men at once, and it's the first time there's a complete absence of karate.
All right. That sounds right.
That sound right? Okay.
Yeah.
And Eddie Fontaine was somebody else that he mentioned. Do you remember working with Eddie on that episode?
Yes, I do.
Oh, okay. Well, Bob, that's all I got for you this week, my friend.
Hey, well, that's enough. It brings me back to yesteryear, and I enjoy it, and I enjoy it, and I enjoy it. Thank you for doing that for me.
It's my pleasure, Bob, and we'll do it again next week if that's all right with you.
Well, of course it's all right with me. Are you kidding me? It's me.
Well, thank you for taking my call. Thank you for your friendship. God bless you all, and I love you like a brother, Bob.
Hey, I love you like a brother too, man, and thanks for the call, okay?
Yes, sir. Thank you for taking my call.
Well, always.
Thank you, Jim.
All right.
There we go.
Talk to you next week.
Yes, sir. Hopefully. Yeah.
Okay.
There he goes. Okay, now we're heading over to our good friend and also the friendly eyes in the sky when it comes to the lounge, Valerie from South Carolina. Val, welcome to your show.
Hi, RC and Eric.
Hey, Val.
Hi, baby.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hi. RC, you look good tonight in dark and gray shirt. I think it's, you know, very becoming on you.
Ooh.
And I had an idea. I was going to throw this at you. You know, your granddaughter, Nikki, is a designer. And I was thinking this week how great it would be if she could design you a line of items that could be called the Wild Wild West Men's Western Wear with your name on it, and have, you know, shirts and belts and boots and that sort of thing. Have you ever thought about having your own clothing line?
No, I haven't actually, because it gets too complicated. And thank you for mentioning that to me, because she's a very talented girl when it comes to designing, but her grandfather's exhausted with the, you know, I don't want to try that on, I don't want to try that on, I don't want to advertise that one. Okay, dear?
I think it would have gone over well, because Western wear is very big, and, you know, she could design for women too, and I think you could make bukus of money. You know,
well,
especially with your name, you know.
Well, there's other things in my life than bukus with money, you know.
You've had plenty of bukus with money, huh?
Well,
yeah.
I've had my share of bukus.
Yes, I wish I had. But I wanted to ask you, could you extend happy birthday wishes to your daughter, Kaja, for me? Because I believe her birthday was yesterday.
Sure, Kaja, happy birthday from yesterday. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, dear Kaja, happy birthday to you.
Hey.
Did you get to see her?
No, but I got to talk to her, I got to sing to her.
Oh, great, great, because I remember she was on last year at this time, and, you know, you had mentioned it was her birthday on April the 5th,
right?
You know. And also, I wondered, did you get the email with the picture of the guy, I think, that looks like you?
No, I haven't seen the guy that looks like me. There's no one that looks like me.
Did you send that picture in? Let me see if I can track it down.
I did. I can resend it now.
No, that's okay. Yeah. Did you send it via? Oh, you did, right here. I got it right here.
Okay, good. Can I see it?
Yeah. Hold it up there.
Okay.
Okay, I put it up there.
Let me see it.
Does
this guy look like me?
Hey, you know, I can see maybe the hair color.
I
think you probably keep yourself in a little bit better shape, but yeah, it kind of resembles you there. I don't know. I'd maybe give it a 6 out of 10 for a likeness.
That fat guy?
Oh, that fat guy. Val, are you going to hang over the break with us?
Yes, I was going to mention.
Okay, good. Stand by, guys. We're not going anywhere. We'll be right back.
He looks like me, seriously.
He kind of does look like you.
Located in the heart of Maui's premier resort, Kaanapali Beach Hotel is officially recognized as Hawaii's most Hawaiian hotel and the number one best value in Hawaii. With a range of accommodations and affordable dining options, this is the ideal setting to turn Hawaiian dreams into lifelong memories. Live Hawaiian entertainment every evening, free year-round children's programs, weekly arts and crafts fairs, welcome breakfast, and departure kukui'ulei ceremonies add to the value. Swim in the whale-shaped pool, indulge in the fabulous spa and hotel salon. Enjoy Hawaiian hospitality at its best at the Kaanapali Beach Hotel. Call 800-262-8450 or go to kbhmaui.com. That's kbhmaui.com. Aloha.
One line open.
Hey guys, Ryan the Rhino DeSico here for my friends at Liberty HealthShare. If your healthcare has become a burden and you're worried about being stuck for another year, listen up, because you do have options. Liberty HealthShare could be the solution to your problem. Open enrollment is here, and this could be your chance to free yourself from insurance. Take this opportunity and join Liberty HealthShare. You can finally be in control and have freedom when it comes to your healthcare. Liberty HealthShare offers an entirely open network, which means you choose your own doctors and you choose your own hospitals. Liberty HealthShare offers freedom from insurance, meaning there are no related tax penalties. To find out how you can easily make the change, call Liberty HealthShare today at 855-585-4237 or visit their website at libertyhealthshare.org. That's libertyhealthshare.org. Do it today.
For the getaway of your dreams, come to Hawaii's Playground, Ka'anapali Beach Resort, on the fun side of Maui, where the world comes to play. Find your spot on Ka'anapali Beach with 3 miles of white sand, 12 resort properties, 2 golf courses, and 2 shopping centers. Enjoy the playground of Hawaii's ancient royalty. Ka'anapali Beach Resort is Hawaii's original master planned destination resort and home of the Hawaii Food and Wine Festival. With views of 2 neighboring islands, you can breathe in the land's natural beauty from your favorite resort or golf fairway. Come experience Ka'anapali's own special brand of Hawaiian hospitality with world-class dining, relaxing resorts, water sports, and activities of every kind. For romantic, family, and great friend getaways, discover the options of Ka'anapali Beach Resort, where the world comes to play. Plan your getaway today. Visit KaanapaliResort.com. That's KaanapaliResort.com.
I'm coming home, baby, now. I'm coming home now, right away. I'm coming home, baby, now. I'm sorry now I ever went away. Every night and day I go and stay. I'm coming home, baby.
Welcome back, everybody, to your show. This is the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad, the Wild, Wild PM Show. I'm Eric Hines, the co-host on this Wild, Wild Ride.
Oh, beautiful. You got it right finally after 2 years.
Thank you. Actually, more like 7.
Thank you. Can you imagine. I finally got it right. Oh,
7 years.
Goodness, yes.
John the Voice was actually posting videos of some of our earliest shows that you and I have done together.
Yes.
When I was just a young man.
Yes, you had to be very young.
Yeah, 7 years ago, I was 32.
You were
33.
You were very young.
Yeah.
But you were part of the show then.
Yes, I was. Yeah.
And you know how I was 7 years ago?
Huh.
25.
Yes, you were, sir.
That's right.
All year long.
Thank you.
Let's get it back to Val in South Carolina. Val, welcome to your show.
Yes, thank you. Well, RC, I thought he looked a little bit like you, more so in person. But
yeah, no, I could tell. As we spent more time looking at the picture, we began to evaluate. And yeah, me and Bob both agree he definitely has a strong resemblance to Bob.
We evaluate?
We just a little bit, we evaluate.
Oh, you're so full of bull.
Just the cheekbones. It was the cheekbones.
Is that what it was?
That was the difference.
Oh, yes. Well,
he has different
whatever
cheekbones.
Whatever you said.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Well, I just wanted to drop in, and I had those things on my mind, and love and blessings to you, RC, and I hope you have a good weekend.
Oh, God bless you, baby, and thanks for the call, and love and blessings to you, girl.
Okay, and you're looking good, and stay healthy for us, okay?
I'll try to. Thanks for the compliment.
Sure. Okay. Bye-bye.
There goes Val. Baby. You know, you'd be amazed, Bob. We now have 2 lines open. So if you've been waiting to call the show.
Two lines open.
Give a call
so
now.
So we have no listeners.
No, we definitely have some listeners, but we have 2 lines open. So that means there's 2 lines for people to call in on.
So we have no listeners.
No, we definitely have listeners.
Okay.
Let's get over to Pat in Michigan and MI. Pat, welcome to your show.
Hi. I'm
Hi.
So glad I got on here. Every time I call, I get on.
Every time you call, you get on?
Yeah, every single time.
Are you Irish, Pat?
Am I Irish? No, I'm German.
Oh, okay. Well, luck of the German, then.
Was ist das?
Yeah, was ist das?
Yeah. I'm German. I had a temper, though, so I don't know.
We don't have
a German
anyway,
temper, yeah.
Do me a favor, will you? Can I talk to the co-host?
I wanted to know.
No, wait.
Hold on, Pat. Hold on a second.
Can I talk to the co-host?
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
All right. Get rid of her.
Oh, no. Hey, Pat.
Oh, you guys are something else.
Uh-huh. He's playing hardball today. Go ahead, Pat.
Thanks, baby girl.
I know. That's okay. Last week you weren't feeling so great. Are you feeling better today?
Oh, yes, I am. I'm feeling wunderbar.
Good. I wanted to also ask you, Was it your idea to start the radio show, or how did you get started with it?
This is the first time I've heard this question in the 7 years that I've done this show.
Well, let me tell you, a simple explanation.
It's a great question.
A friend of mine was doing the show, and he couldn't do it, and he decided to ask his girlfriend if I would be interested in doing it, and she asked me, and I said, nah, I don't think so, but what the hell, I'll give it a try, and then I never stopped.
Good for you.
Thanks.
And wow. That's you, though. Everything you do, you try, and you're always successful at it. That's really good.
Well, I tried it, and I liked it, so there you have it.
Yeah. Well, thank God. I can't remember too many movie stars that will take the time to talk to the people that watch the shows and stuff. You're probably one of the only ones.
Well, I don't know about that. All I know is I enjoy talking to the people, and the more I started, the more I wanted to turn it over to the audience, and now it has become their show.
I talk to you after the break.
It's the long one, Pat, but hang in there, okay?
You want to wait a long break?
Okay.
Here we go. Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up here on the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. Stick in there on the lounge, chat with friends, watch the in-studio video, and we'll be back right after this on CRN Digital Talk Radio. News and more right here.
CRN Digital Talk Radio prides itself on being the station of every situation. Of course, you can always listen live through your local cable TV provider, as well as on our website at crntalk.com. But if cutting-edge technology is more your style, you'll be happy to know that CRN is now available on Wi-Fi radio. Simply log on to receiva.com. That's receiva.com, and look for CRN. You can access all of our great shows and listen live anywhere in the world. Be part of your favorite shows and get the full CRN listening experience you would have with any traditional radio, podcast, or a live stream from our website. For more information on where or how to listen, and for a full list of our programming, log on to crntalk.com and create your own listening experience today.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson says in the wake of the chemical attack in northern Syria that's killed at least 72 people, the U.S. is evaluating an appropriate response.
There is no doubt in our minds, and the information we have supports, that Syria, the Syrian regime under the leadership of President Bashar al-Assad, are responsible for this attack.
Tillerson also said President Assad should no longer have a role in governing the Syrian people. The Senate has cleared the way for a Friday confirmation vote on President Trump's nominee for the Supreme Court, Neil Gorsuch. Utah Senator Orrin Hatch announces the Senate has voted that an old rule is no longer effectively voting to exercise the nuclear option.
On this vote, the ayes are 48, the nays are 52. The decision of the chair does not stand as the judgment of the Senate.
Under the new rules, the Senate voted 55-45 to move ahead on the nomination. After the standard 30 hours of debate, Gorsuch is expected to be confirmed. Democrats had done the same thing in 2013 to pave the way for a series of Obama appointees to lower courts and administration positions. House Intelligence Committee Chairman Devin Nunes is temporarily stepping away from the investigation into Russian meddling in last year's election.
That after the Ethics Committee announced it was investigating allegations that Nunes may have made unauthorized disclosures of classified information. Members of both parties have questioned Nunes' ability to oversee an independent investigation ever since he briefed President Trump on surveillance information before informing members of his own committee. Nunes calls the allegations against him false and politically motivated.
Capitol Hill correspondent Wally Hines reporting. On Wall Street, the Dow by 15 points to 20,663. The NASDAQ rose 14. The S&P advanced 5. Oil up 55 cents to $51.70 a barrel. More on these stories at townhall.com.
I'm Nick Soboleski, a SelectQuote agent with a true story that could save you hundreds of dollars a year. A woman named Linda just called. Her husband, Ray, has a $300,000 group life insurance policy, but is changing jobs and can't take it with him. Well, I impartially shopped the highly rated term life insurance companies we represent and found Ray, who is 41 and takes medication to control his cholesterol, a 10-year, $500,000 policy, for under $26 a month. That's almost twice the coverage for less than half of what he had paid. If SelectQuote hasn't shopped for your life insurance, you're probably paying too much.
For your free quote, call 1-800-613-4704. That's 1-800-613-4704. 1-800-613-4704. Or go to SelectQuote.com. We shop, you save. Get full details on the example policy at SelectQuote.com/commercials. Your price could vary depending on your health, issuing company, and other factors. Not available in all states.
The global Muslim population is set to catch up with the Christian population in the coming decades.
With 2.3 billion adherents, Christianity is the world's largest religion. But social scientists at the Pew Research Center say that a Muslim baby boom is on the horizon, which means Muslim births will exceed those of Christians by 2035. According to a new Pew report, the world's two largest religions will have a near equal share of the global population by 2060. Other religious groups, including Hindus and Jews, will grow in total numbers by 2060, but will not keep pace with global population growth. A low birth rate for people who don't affiliate with any religion means that their share of the world population will also shrink. I'm Walter Ratliff.
John Glenn, the first American to orbit the Earth, has been laid to rest in a private burial at Arlington National Cemetery. Glenn died in December at age 95, and his family scheduled the funeral for what would have been his 74th wedding anniversary with wife Annie. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Thousands of visitors are expected in Kansas City at its towering World War I monument known as Liberty Memorial. Shirley Smith reports.
Dignitaries from around the world are converging on Kansas City for the 100th anniversary of the day that the U.S. entered the Great War. The event is titled In Sacrifice for Liberty and Peace, and it'll be on the grounds at the National World War I Museum and Memorial. Matt Naylor is president of that facility. He points out that even though there will be music and poetry and speeches, it's not a celebration. He calls it a commemoration. By the time American military muscle helped vanquish Germany and the conflict ended in 1918, more than 9 million people were lost to combat. Some 116,000 of them were Americans. I'm Shirley Smith.
Historians have stated that people around the world, indeed all of us, are still dealing, even 100 years later, with the effects of that war. More on these stories at townhall.com.
You're experiencing pain, back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain, pain from a sports injury. If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422.
Hi, this is Bill Martinez. Join us every Monday through Friday from 9 to noon Eastern when we're covering the issues that matter most to you. From Obamacare, the latest from Russia, the Middle East, Israel, immigration, and more. We're talking with the policy and political experts so you can be better informed. It's Bill Martinez Live, brought to you in part by my friends at Good News Tax Relief. Let them help you get your peace of mind back by dealing with the IRS for you. Proven experience, proven results. Call 800-255-7500.
Welcome back, everybody, to your show. This is the fastest hour in radio. This is the PM show with Mr. Robert Conrad, the man of this hour. Of course, I am Eric Hines, the consummate host on this wild, wild ride. And you, giving us a call here at 818-818-6401.
What does that mean, consummate?
It means I help. I'm like the peanut butter in this peanut butter and jelly sandwich. I kind of finish it. I kind of wrap it all up. Oh, actually, no. I'd be like the bread in the peanut butter and jelly sandwich. You're the peanut butter. You're the peanut butter. The listeners are the jelly, and I'm the bread.
It worked for me.
Okay. Anyways, guys, welcome to your show. Of course, you can give us a call, 818-818-6401. 818-818-6401. 818-818-6401.
818-6401.
Yeah.
All good children have fun.
I like that.
When they get there, they repeat, JMA cannot be beat.
We were last, when we took over for the break, we were talking with Pat from Jackson, Michigan. Let's bring Pat into the show. Pat, welcome to your show. Pat, you there?
Go ahead.
Oh, there we go. Hey, Pat.
Pat.
I was listening to the peanut butter and jelly thing. What the hell?
I'm sorry. I think I confused more people than I enlightened.
Yeah, I can't get it either. Yeah. I don't know. What the hell is he talking about? Peanut butter and jelly.
My metaphor didn't work.
I wanted to ask you, you've been doing this radio for a long time. Is there any questions that you ever wondered why people didn't ask you?
Me?
Yeah.
Well, they've asked me if I had an illegitimate relationship. They asked me how many times I was married. They asked me how tall I was, and a couple other unimportant questions that I just thought were not silly.
But is there any ones that you wondered why nobody asked?
Question again.
Is there any questions that you wondered why nobody ever asked you?
I don't think so. What do you think, Eric?
Yeah, I'm trying to think. Yeah, no, I mean, we've gotten so many questions. The one that we heard today that I've never heard before is, what got you started in the show? I thought that was a really good question. So that would be my number one contender if it was not asked tonight.
Well, it's never been asked, but
can you guys hear me that good?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay.
Can you hear us? Can you hear us?
Well, yeah, I can hear you guys really good, but we're having lots of sleep and shit here today, so anyway, I was wondering, when you're feeling better, what kind of things do you want to do?
I'm feeling better now, baby. I mean, I could go to work to Monday. I'm feeling all right. It's not that I'm on the downgrade, but just the truth. You know, sometimes you say, how you feeling? Well, I got a cold. That's all. Everything's good. Everything is seriously good. About what? I'm 82 years old, sweetheart. What do you think I'm planning on doing?
Well, you're doing something right now.
Well, Pat.
Yeah, but this is fun. I'm not looking at this as a job. This is fun.
We'll talk to you next week, Pat. Bye-bye.
Listen, this whole do-it-yourself thing is fine for some projects, but when it comes to window coverings, not so much.
Tell me about it. I did some do-it-yourself shades that are best described as uneven and twisted.
Yeah, I've seen them. That's why I'm going with Budget Blinds.
That's a style and service for every budget people, right?
Yeah, and that is for real. Budget Blinds has no surprises pricing and a no-questions-asked warranty. The best in the business.
No surprises pricing and a no-questions-asked warranty?
No-brainer, right?
So Budget Blinds comes in, measures everything, orders for you, then they install it all?
It's a beautiful thing. And now you can get up to $500 off on Signature Series window coverings.
Another no-brainer. Number, please.
855-BUDGET-BLINDS. Or go online to budgetblinds.com.
Call 855-BUDGET-BLINDS and get the experts to do it for you at a price that fits your budget.
Call 855-BUDGET-BLINDS now.
Offer good on selected products at participating independently owned and operated franchises only. Some restrictions may apply. Ask for details.
I don't care what I've been told. How your love will soon grow cold. How someday you will be untrue. Because I just gotta have you. say you'll break my heart. That you're only playing a part. But there's nothing that I can do because I just gotta have you.
Welcome back, everybody. This is your show, the Wild Wild PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. And thank you so much for joining us. And also, thank you for joining us in the lounge at tikilive.com. TikiLive.com. Be sure to check it out. Just search for CRN. It's a place where they can watch the live in-studio video footage of you over there, Mr. Conrad, and me over here. And, of course, chat with other CRN viewers.
All right, if you say so.
I believe you. You got to trust me on this
one. I don't know if I have to trust you, but I believe you.
Okay, thank you, sir. I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Let's get over to Boston now and talk to Susie. Susie, welcome to your show.
Well, hello, and how you doing, Robert and Eric? You look, both of you look so handsome.
Oh, handsome? Oh, thanks, I love Susie. Your accent from Boston. We look handsome, huh?
Oh, yes, you both do. Yes, and I'm glad you're feeling better, Robert, because you're looking better.
Well, I'm not going to share it anymore with the Boston audience, because you know what? It's more about nothing. You know, it was just something that happened, and I normally wouldn't have said it, but I told
Don't you worry.
Well, I do worry because I said a very obscure circumstance, and it's become a major incident now. I've heard every call has been the same
thing. I wasn't talking about that anyways. Well, I was talking about how good you look.
Oh, well, I like that.
I think it's because you've been working out.
Well, I like that. All right, go ahead.
Yeah.
All right, where are we?
I have a question.
I have an answer.
Good. We love this show so much, and I can't believe that I've been listening for 3 years, and it's been on for 10 years. When you were first asked by Mike Horn to do the show, did you think it was only going to be like a couple of week thing, or maybe like a few months, or how did you feel when you first heard about this?
I thought it was going to be a couple of week thing. That's all, you know, going to amuse me, and I did it for my friend who was on leave, and I did it, and I've done it now, and now it's fun, and I've had a couple of co-hosts, I guess that's what they're called.
Apparently,
and that's been fun, and it's been a good experience for me.
It's been a very good experience for us, and we are so glad that Eric is the consummate co-host and back with us again.
Thanks, Susie.
Thank you, Susie.
Yes, and I hope you, in case I don't get the chance to talk to you next week, I want to make sure you had a very good, blessed Easter, because I know you're like me. You know the real reason of Christmas and Easter. And so I wish you and your family a very blessed Easter, and God bless you.
Hey, God bless you, and thanks for what you just said. I appreciate that.
Yes, my prayers are with you daily, dearie.
Thank you, dear.
And you too, Eric.
Thanks, Susie.
Tell Eric.
Okay, take care, guys.
I'll talk to you later.
What do you want me to tell Eric?
Well, she's just telling me, same for me, about the, good salutations.
Yeah, but you have to wait till you hear them.
Yeah, well, I heard it.
Well, I didn't.
Oh, I'm sorry. Susie, are you still there?
Yes, I'm still here.
Okay, Bob wants you to repeat your salutations to us.
I said that I say prayers for Bob every day, and I say prayers for Eric, too, and Sarah.
Oh, thank you so much.
Well, thank you, darling.
Thank you, Susie.
Thank you.
I feel blessed,
we're all part of the family.
Yeah. I like that.
Well, that's kind of you, and I appreciate it, because, Eric kind of rushes away when you're finished.
I don't rush away.
Yeah, you do.
No way.
What are you giggling about, darling?
Because I think from looking at his Facebook, I think he just wants to rush home to his wife and family.
I think you're right, yes. Just rush home, you turkey.
Well, Susie, I would incriminate myself if I was to say anything other than that, so there you go.
Thanks, baby.
Yes. Okay. Take care, guys.
Thank
and
you,
I love
sweetie.
You. Good night.
Thank you, Susan.
I love you too.
She's such a sweetheart. All right. Let's get over to Gabby in San Antonio. Our number one caller of the day, Gabby, of course, writing an unauthorized biography of Mr. Robert Conrad. Let's see what she has for us today. Gabby, welcome to your show.
Unauthorized. Hey, did my money
Eric,
fall out?
Hi, Robert.
Hi, Gabby.
What fell out of my pocket?
Hopefully, it wasn't all that money you put in that pocket.
It was.
I'll go take a look at the break. I'll find it for you.
Yeah, will you find it? Please?
Yeah, I'm hoping that all that money isn't missing by the time I find
it.
I'm really
serious.
Hoping. No, I'll take care of you. Don't worry about it.
Well, I am worried about it.
And I'll take care of the ride home, too. And I'll take care of dinner tonight, and I'll take care of everything else.
Yeah, just get the money at the break.
Okay.
Okay,
sure,
God bless America.
No problem, amigo. Go ahead.
Right, thanks.
Welcome, Gabby.
Hello. I wanted to ask you about that movie, La Nueva
Siena
La Nueva Santa Sienta?
Yeah.
What about it?
Yes. On that one, I remember you told me it was a musical, but did it also include regular dialogue?
Yeah. In Spanish.
Right. So you actually did the dialogue in Spanish?
Yes, I did.
Besides that one, I know there was another movie you did that was Spanish language, but were there, like, other movies besides those two that you had done in, you know, Spanish language?
No.
No, those were the only two, that one and the other one was Los Bandidos?
Los Bandidos.
Los Banditos.
Right.
Los Bandidos, yeah. Those were the only two Spanish ones that you had done, Spanish language?
Yes, darling.
Okay, and I think I remember on another show you mentioned that you had done some albums in Spanish?
Some albums, yeah, singing. Mm-hmm.
Did you keep copies of those albums or anything?
No.
Oh.
Oh.
I would have liked to have been able to find them and hear them.
Yeah, I wonder if that stuff's up on
YouTube. I would like
to have
been able to find them and hear them. Would you mind looking for the money that
are
I
you? You're from? Okay, I'll go right now. Go Please. Ahead. Keep talking with our friend Gabby.
Okay, Gabby, I'll talk to you for a few moments. What are you laughing at? Huh?
I'm just happy. I'm always happy to talk to you, and it always makes me smile and laugh when I'm listening to you and Eric.
Oh, you know what, sweetheart? Yeah, he just got up to feel my the side of my leg to see if my money was there.
We're really close here. In
Are
the
you
studio.
Ready to talk to us or no? You, dear.
Gabby, still there?
Yes, I'm still here.
Any other questions for Bob, Gabby?
So those are my only ones for today.
All right. Well, thank you, sweetie.
You sound like you're falling asleep.
Thank you all. And I hope to talk to you all again next week. Wow. So Sarah said hi.
Were you falling asleep just now?
No.
Okay. Why do you sound like you're yawning?
Well, I was tired earlier, but I'm not really tired right now.
All right. Well, wake up when you talk. Come on. You're one of the co-hosts of the show.
All right, well, I'll let you go so that someone else can get on and, you know, ask you their questions and stuff.
Thanks, Gabby.
How sweet, Gabby. Appreciate it.
She's a sweetheart, yeah.
All right. God bless you all, and I hope to talk to you all again next week.
We'll talk to you
okay,
soon, Gabs.
Okay, God bless you, and I hope to talk to you, dear.
Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up here on the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. I'm Eric Hines. We're taking your calls. We have two lines open.
Wow. Two lines open.
818-818-6401. That's 818.
818-6401.
That's
Why do we have two lines open?
We're going to fill them up right now.
They don't want to talk to us?
Well, I hope they do.
Well, I hope they do. If they don't want to talk to us, they may want to talk to you.
Well, let's talk to one of us.
Well, I don't know about that.
We'll be back right after this.